Okay. I hope everybody can see that. Pretty clear.
It's amazing.
Yeah, it's pretty mind-blowing. Now, folks, this was the HI-1 ahead. This is coming from, I believe this is Secchi, correct?
It is Secchi, yeah.
Yeah, this is the Secchi L2. Now, this was dated back in 2013, and this goes back to the very beginning of the year, January. And you're seeing time-lapse video, and what I've done is I've placed a few different colored filters on this to give us a little bit of a different perspective. Well, Dr. Olivers, you want to go ahead and you want to narrate a little bit on what you're actually seeing?
Well, what we're seeing is a very large object moving towards the sun. That's, I think this is the one that they labeled as Jupiter, isn't it?
Well, on the older footage that I looked up on Secchi, it doesn't look anything like this. It just looks like the regular SRAM image, and it doesn't even have this coronal mass ejection occurring.
Okay.
I looked at all of the ultraviolet filtered images, and I could see absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing at all.
So, you see, on the stereo images, the sun is actually quite small. It's about the same size as it would be on the core, too. So that means this object is absolutely huge. And don't forget, stereo, the stereo spacecraft is on the same orbit as the Earth. So, for example, if this was Jupiter, and Jupiter is not in the inner solar system, it's in the outer solar system beyond Earth, so it would be seeing Jupiter on the other side of the solar system, if it was seeing Jupiter at all. So Jupiter would be 7 AU away, at least, because the orbital distance between for Jupiter is about 5 AU. So this object, if it was Jupiter, would be 7 AU away from the spacecraft. That's 7 times further than the Earth's distance to the sun. Jupiter is only 1/10 the size of the sun. So this object is absolutely huge. And it's not just this object. We can see in some of this footage, you can see lots of other material around it. Some of it seems to be moving with it. Some of it seems to be moving independently. But there seems to be a whole cloud of material moving in. You can see here, right behind it. You can see lots and lots of material. And these are the things that I've been saying are there in the stereo images, but it's very difficult to see because they defocus the images so we don't see these details. But here we're starting to see them. There's lots and lots. There's a whole cloud of material coming in behind this object.
Yeah, these still photographs I captured from the video after I turned the video into ultra high definition. I went ahead and played it in slow motion, so I was able to capture some really good still photographs. And we'll get into those still photographs shortly. And folks, I don't know what else to say anymore other than yes, there will always be people out there that are skeptical. There will always be people out there that want to debunk what you are showing people. Now, if you're showing people complete nonsense, then that's understandable. We're not here to deceive anybody. We're simply here to show you what we have found over the years. And the fact of the matter is, there are a lot of people out there that do not want you to know about this.
Thank you.
oi, 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 oi.